everyone. I am live with Melody, the founder of StyleSeat. I am super excited to have you. I'm thanking you so much for this interview in advance. You look so fantastic. Your hair looks cute.
Oh my gosh, thanks, girl. I gotta learn from you. Encouraged out. I need to step my game up a little.
You know what? It's just because when I'm on video, I'm always like, I've got to be like done up for whatever reason. So, but you're in my living room, so welcome to my living room.
It looks fantastic. Welcome to my hotel room. It's just fancy.
Right, because you're in New York, so you're not on West Coast time. Are you a little jet lagged? Did you just get there today?
I did. I woke up at like 4 a.m. New York time, so I don't know where I am. My body doesn't know where I am, but I'm feeling good.
Oh, great, great, great. Well, you have so much more energy than I would after traveling all day, so I tip my hat to you. So of course, I've got a couple of little questions. I really am super excited to have you. So I even actually asked a couple of my groups on Facebook, some business groups, and they had some really good questions. So cool. I hope you're ready.
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Fire away. Okay, great. So I love StyleSeat. So I'll start there. I love StyleSeat. I think I introduced to it, I say a couple of years ago, I found the website and I was like, this is a really cool idea. Everybody needs the opportunity to be able to book a stylist, book a manicurist, book a facial, be able to book these services that are super, you know, essential to being a woman, right? But it's really hard, especially if you're traveling or you travel a lot like you do, you know, I travel. So you want to be able to seamlessly go into any market and say, I can book a service, you know. So that's what I love about StyleSeat. And I'm a tech girl myself, so I love that it's super mobile friendly. Yes. And, you know, it's got this really great, you know, like it looks great. And, you know, that's what I'm always thinking of as a user. So that's me. But, you know, this is about you being an entrepreneur. So that's part of this conversation. So, some of the questions I got were, what were your inspiration in starting StyleSeat?
Yeah, you know, I came from the tech world, actually. A lot of people ask me if I was a stylist. I'm not a stylist, but I was a client. I moved to San Francisco for the first time. This was a little while ago, but at the time I was looking for someone to cut and also color my hair. And in San Francisco, the combination of those two things is over $300. It's pretty expensive.
And wow.
I know. And I was sort of like, all right, I'm busy. I wait a long time in between services. I just want to find someone who's good and convenient and near me. And there were things that I needed. It was like I need them to be the right price, the right sort of style, aesthetic. I need them to specialize in what I want. You know, at the time I had dark hair. I've had every color hair, by the way. But at the time I had like black, dark brown hair. And so I was like, I want someone that can do color really well. And I did what everyone does, which is go online to review sites and also ask girlfriends where they go. And through those two channels, I went to three different people over the course of like a year, year and a half. And just wasn't happy, didn't find someone who was great. And then I went to someone who was fantastic. And the difference in feeling between like, it's okay, and like, oh my God, I feel like a queen, I feel amazing, I have confidence, you know, she's helping me. I naturally have pretty curly hair. She's helping me to tame it, and I have the right products. Like, that difference is amazing, and there was no difference in price. So what I wanted to do is figure out a way to make everyone feel like that last way, every time they want to book services. You know, I wasn't like super into beauty. I just wanted an easy way. And so the idea of StyleSeat sort of stemmed from that, is being able to search based on what you want, look at photos, and book from your phone.
Nice. Nice. I think that's great. And so what year was that? Tell me where we're at in technology world. Because, oh, you know, I'm a tech girl too, so.
That was probably, I mean, if I were to guess, I would say 2010. So that was a while ago, almost 4 years ago. And I had just been sitting on the idea for StyleSeat for about 2 years up until that point. And I was too scared to start it. I thought, like, every person that's ever started a technology company is brilliant savants and amazing, and, you know, you have to go to Harvard, Stanford. I'll never be able to do this. And finally, I woke up one day, and I was like, you know what? If I don't do this, I'm going to regret this for the rest of my life. I really want to start this business. I'm obsessed with this. I can't stop thinking about it. And so I sort of just took the leap and did it.
Nice. I love that. And you're right. 4 years ago doesn't sound like a long time, but in tech world, that's like ancient history.
That makes us like a granny startup at this point. It's totally true.
Right, you're like, you're an old school startup. You've been around for quite some time.
Exactly, you know, right? Exactly.
And, you know, and that's the thing. So I've got even some notes here. So some people were saying, like, you know, you guys are an angel-backed company. That's like a big deal.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, as far as, you know, startups go, everybody's always like, they're like, they want that like fairy tale, like, you know, business idea that like takes them, you know, that somebody else sees a value in. And so many women see the value of StyleSeat. So, you know, tell me what that process was like, because more of my audience is mostly, you know, entrepreneurs. They're professionals themselves, professionals in the beauty world like you. Like I said, people always think I'm a makeup artist. I'm not. I'm just a person who has an affinity for those, you know, professionals and those working hard in the industry. So tell me, like, what was that like, you know, taking your idea from idea paper to, you know, now being what it is. What was that journey for you? How was that journey?
Well, so I started the company with my co-founder, Dan Levine, and yep. We were so excited about this that we had done all of our homework. So the industry is huge. No one had done this before. The stylists wanted it. We had all these interviews and this proof. Consumers wanted it. And we took it to VCs and we were like, we have this idea. It's amazing. It checks all the boxes of anyone that would want to fund a company that has potential. You know, amazing co-founder Dan has built huge businesses before on the tech side, and all the data was there. And investors were basically like, "Oh, Miss McCloskey, you want to start a hair technology startup? No, thank you." I couldn't have gotten left out of town harder. It was, those first meetings were so funny. I mean, they couldn't have said no faster.
Wow.
Because they believed that no stylist would use technology. They didn't think, I got told several times, women don't actually spend that much on their hair. You know, many of them said, oh, my wife doesn't spend very much on beauty. And I would laugh at them and say, well, maybe you should ask her. And I got a lot of funny emails, like, after the fact. They were like, oh, my God, my wife spends so much on beauty. But part of the stuff is that women, they get these services done and so that they don't seem like they've had them done, and they're not spending a lot of money or putting effort into it. That's, like, the magic.
Right. It's like the guy behind the curtain, right?
Yeah, exactly. And a lot of just nerdy guys in Silicon Valley didn't get it. And so me and my co-founder basically said, okay, we're going to go and we're just going to build this business on our own. We're not going to take any capital for now. We're just going to get businesses, get stylists on the platform. Let's drive a lot of value. Let's grow it on the stylist side. Let's prove that consumers want this and they'll use it. And let's grow our metrics, and then we'll have these conversations again. So we did that we bootstrapped for about a year and a half. And then we raised our first round of seed capital, and that was exciting. And a lot of those guys were friends of mine that were like, look, Mel, I don't know anything about beauty, but I think that you're a hustler, and these metrics that you've built over the past year and a half, while I don't know very much about hairstylists, these are really interesting. Like, these numbers can't lie. So I'm going to invest in this data and in you, and then we'll see. And, you know, from there until now, we've built a community of 250,000 businesses, these hairstylists, makeup artists, estheticians, nail artists, etc. we've powered over $500 million in appointments across our platform since launching, and we have millions of client users. So just because people tell you no doesn't mean that the business isn't there.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I tip my hat to you, because you're right. So many people don't understand, and I'm in that tech space, and I teach that type of stuff to professionals and beauty professionals who have this thought about technology, and some of them are scared, but they know that every customer, every client they have is using some sort of technology at this moment. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not like 10 years ago when nobody had a phone in their pocket, you know, or very few people had a phone in their pocket. Everything is mobile. And, you know, you're right, people are on the go and they're looking for some way to really connect. That I'm in that same place right now. I'm growing my hair out thinking, okay, I need someone who can do natural curly hair. You know, and I know you guys are growing in Chicago, so that's like a big plus for me. You know, to be able to find someone who can do what it is I'm looking for, because I was a blowout girl. Like in my 20s, that was every Friday I was in a salon chair every Friday afternoon, early evening, getting my hair blown out.
Yeah.
So I didn't own a dryer. I didn't own my own dryer in my 20s. Isn't that crazy?
Oh my gosh, I'm jealous.
I was that girl. I was very, you know, like,
I owned fantastic. I just could not use it for the life of me. My hair came out like this every single time. I'd spend an hour doing it. It was just, I mean, it was so sad. I've learned a little bit since then because I have good teachers, but yeah.
Right, exactly. It's always this struggle, and it never looked like it did in the salon. So literally, I remember being in a pageant and I literally had to have a stylist come to my hotel room on a Sunday to do it, because it's this curly naturally. So it was like, if you don't come and do it today, it's not going to look like anything.
Yeah.
I totally think you captured what every woman was needing in the marketplace. And as a businesswoman, you know, so many salons are run by women. I think you give them that power to see that a woman can be techie and can be savvy in a businesswoman. I think that's the greatest lesson that you as the face and one of the founders of this business is really, really key to. Okay.
Yeah. And I think one of the key takeaways is, you know, these guys who aren't part of this community said, like, I don't think that stylists will use technology. And that's what a lot of people said, because that was sort of the thought. And the reality is, absolutely. Are you kidding me? Everyone wants to grow their business. Everyone wants to look stylish and look polished. And of course, we're going to open our phones and do that. You're ridiculous. If you give that people a nice enough product, then they'll use it. And that's sort of what we've learned.
Absolutely. I think that's amazingly key. And so why is it, do you think, like, what's been your biggest hurdles in going into the salons? Because you just mentioned that people were saying that, you know, stylists won't use technology. And for a very long time, they didn't have to use technology to do their business. You know, they're great artists, and they're not, and some of them aren't really great business people. So what's the hurdles you guys run into when you go into a salon and say, hey, I've got this amazing app that would, you know, totally transform your business. If you used it, it would transform that ratty old, you know, notebook that your receptionist is using at the front. You know, yeah. That's been working for years. My phone's still ringing, people still making appointments. What's been your biggest hurdle in getting them from that old school mindset to this new mind shift in terms of technology being the way, not the way of the future, the way of right now? Like, yeah. I'm making money right now on the internet. How's that?
Well, I think part of the message of what we try and let people know about is, you know, a lot of stylists, and this would probably go if you're building a company for small business owners, a lot of them say, well, what I have is not convenient, but it's sort of working. And you know, the reality is our biggest competitor is pen and paper. And pen and paper sort of works. Like, it's accurate 90 to 95% of the time. So you're going to see, like, you have churn rates, you have sort of your expectancy of success, and it generally lives up to that. What that misses, however, that frame of thinking, is what you're actually losing by continuing on the same system. So it's not even that you're, you know, a lot of them are just fearful of losing money, but the reality is by not switching over to technology, they are losing money because customers more and more are moving over onto that platform. So it's not even like, no, I'm just going to stay the same to keep the same customers and not take advantage of new. The reality is actually you are losing customers, and more, even though it's a trickle right now, are moving towards these online solutions because whereas a couple of years ago, maybe we would wait and we'd play a little phone tag. We had kind of the patience for it. Now we don't. Now we're booking our cars from our phone. You know, in San Francisco, it's a little, it's nerdy, but like everyone buys their groceries from their phone. They're getting ingredients delivered to their door to take home and cook. They're getting people to come help them with laundry or help clean their houses or, you know, anything that you need done, TaskRabbit to do odds and ends. More and more, we expect instantaneous gratification. And while it was sort of a nice to have a couple of years ago, now it's becoming more and more a need to have. And, you know, we grow the average stylist revenue by 70% in the first year just by making their business more efficient and giving them access to these new customers that are using our solution. That's really what you're missing out on, is that 70% growth. That's massive, right? That's a reason to switch over to a new system. And so it's a matter of not just looking at where I am right now and should I take a risk or jump through a hoop to get a little bit better. It's should I do a little bit to completely transform my business.
That is, you're right. Like, I couldn't, there's no way I could argue with that number. It's 70%.
I know. It's crazy. It's crazy.
Gosh. like, I was expecting you to say, like, you know, something really conservative, like, oh, like 40, like, oh, yeah, I can see that. People being excited about that. But over half.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Almost 3/4 of your business completely transformed.
Yes.
By just being able to track and understand and then be able to see trends.
Yeah. A lot of it, I'd say, is that we cut the time in half that your clients wait in between your appointments. So as you're sitting there, you know, with your clients, we're doing reminders, thank yous, follow-ups. We're sending emails and text messages on your behalf. Not overkill. You know, we know what clients want and don't want. We send just the right amount of communication so that they go, oh, yeah, I should, next week should be, you know, my time for my next appointment. Okay, yes, I'll click on this link and book it. Instead of that time passing, and they're like, oh, no, I need to book an appointment, and then another week passes because life is busy, and then they finally get around to it the following week, and then they book it the following week. And as that happens, you know, over the course of a year, they can come to you 3 less times. And that's hundreds of dollars that you missed is not necessarily tracked in your existing on pen and paper. Pen and paper is not going to tell you that, but that's the reality. And so using tools like the ones that we offer are tremendous for small business owners.
And so many people are used to, like you said, in San Francisco, that automation. I remember, and you know, my dad's been one of those very first, you know, early adopters of, right, delivered groceries. We were getting delivered groceries when I was in high school, and that was, like, super unheard of. People thought we were rich. People were like, you get your groceries delivered? It was like, yeah, because my dad travels all the time.
Yeah.
And it's either that or we don't have food in the house. Like, yeah. Or, you know, so it was like, and he was super duper, like, one of those, like, first people, like, oh, they will pick it out for me and bring it to my house? This is revolutionary, you know?
Yeah.
You know, and so people are very used to that, like you said, that instant gratification, that online experience, and that, you know, that reminder. We're used to that reminder. Like, have you ever, I'm sure you've missed probably 4 or 5 meetings in a year that you were like, oh, or you were late to because you were like, I didn't get a reminder.
Mm-hmm.
100%. I didn't get a reminder. You're like, oh, shoot, I didn't get a reminder. and so, you know, right, so remind me, I need, my eyebrows waxed, my lip waxed, I need my hair cut, it was been 6 weeks since I got my last color. You're absolutely right. Make it easy for me. Make it this low-hanging fruit for the customer. Totally transforms your business. That is phenomenal. That's phenomenal. So I know you guys are growing. Tell me a little bit about that process and how that's been in terms of really kind of jumping into some new markets. I know where are you guys coming soon?
Yes, so we're in 15,000 cities today, but we're starting to see some exceptionally strong growth in our top markets. So we're starting to spend more and more time in Atlanta and Chicago, our first most big cities that we're excited about. So we've actually sent teams out to those cities to do some team building. I've come out to both of those cities a few times, and we're going to start to throw more and more events and fun pop-ups and starting to connect both our stylist communities in those cities and also the client communities and connecting people who love style and who want the great deals and the best professionals and kind of bringing them all together.
Nice, nice. So Chicago and Atlanta, those are some, you're right, everybody's moving to Atlanta. I just had a conversation with a friend last week. She's like, you don't want to move to Atlanta with me. And I was like, no, I don't.
It's pretty great. I just got back from there. It's pretty fun.
It is. I love it. It's a great city. I have this thing about the South, but that's another story. it's just like, I'm like, it's so slow. Like, yes, Atlanta's very emerging, but it's starting to be very techy.
Yeah.
But it's starting to be very, very techy.
I'm so impatient, though. I mean, I live in San Francisco, and you can get from one end to the city and another. I never budget more than, like, 15 minutes. I'm like, here, other end, great, we're good, call an Uber, easy. Like, in Atlanta, it's kind of like L.A., where you have to plan, and there's logistics, and there's, like, traffic, there's Google Maps involved, and, like, multiple apps, and, you know, people are like, well, yeah, that's only a couple miles away, but there's traffic. Like, it takes time and people. So that's something I had to get over because I'm really impatient. So I'm like, let's just get there. Let's go.
People are like, right, I'm like, no. Uber. I'm like, Uber will get me there in 10 minutes. Like, I live 10 minutes from anything downtown. Like, I legitimately live within 10 minutes of downtown.
Amazing.
And I'm super impatient. And I'm like, and then I give bad ratings when they go the wrong way. I'm like, oh, they went the wrong way.
Yeah. It took me 11 minutes. This is ridiculous.
Right? This is a 5-minute drive. It took me 11 minutes. So, okay, so Chicago, right. You're coming to Chicago. That's my hometown.
Yep.
So tell me about some of the really fun and exciting things you're going to be doing here in Chicago.
Couple things. We're going to be throwing some stylist events and meetups that I'm excited about. We're going to be doing a lot of press and PR, so meeting with influencers, movers and shakers in Chicago and writers and just telling them what we're excited about. So both supporting small businesses in Chicago, you know, helping a lot of these stylists, barbers, nail techs, makeup artists really grow their business and connect in new and different ways to customers, to businesses, you know, really grow their revenue. And on the other side, helping consumers with a lot of cool new consumer features. We're also going to throw a consumer event when we're out there. There'll be a party. It'll be fun just to get the word out and get some buzz going on what we're doing. And
I can't wait to go. That's my shameless plug.
Yeah, let's do it. I'm excited. Drinks on us.
Yay! So that's amazing. So where do you see, so anything fun that you would like to see happen or really that you guys are really trying to grind towards? What's a goal you guys are really trying to grind towards in 2015?
Yeah, so we're really excited about starting to really understand the flavor of different cities. We focused a lot up until this point. I mean, we've been a tiny team. Last year we were 8 people at this time. We were really small. Now we've grown, but we're it's been like, let's just grow StyleSeat. Anyone who wants to use it, let's just get the word out. Let's make the tool better. Now we're starting to really understand different cities, and when we can better understand the flavor of Chicago versus Atlanta versus Miami versus Seattle, LA, like, then we'll really turn on that market. So it's figuring out, for example, like the services that are done in Atlanta and the makeup of Atlanta and what people care about is the opposite of Seattle, for example. Very different from New York, very different from San Francisco. And so that's why we're sending teams out there to really understand what people want and deliver them those types of experiences. So our app will be completely different on a city-by-city basis. How we market, the services that we push, the partnerships that we have, it'll all be very city-based. I'm excited about that.
Nice. I'm excited to see you guys here in Chicago. That's, you know, when I got, I was like, yes, I'm familiar with StyleSeat. Okay, yes, like, that's exciting to me. you know, in the beauty industry, there are, I'm like a beauty news geek, so I'm not necessarily the one who's like, oh, there's a new, well, I am about the new shade of lipstick, but I'm also more so excited about the business pieces of things that are happening, and especially since StyleSeat is coming to Chicago, what that means for this market and definitely the makeup artists that I know in this market who can definitely utilize something like this to be able to really kind of push their businesses a little bit further, to be able to market their businesses a little bit better, really kind of take back some of their time. You know, I love the idea. I love that pen and paper is your biggest competitor because it is. But definitely, it's a great way of looking at it, and I think you guys have a really great shot at really pushing this industry forward in a really great technology way. I'm really excited about that.
Thank you.
I can't wait for you guys to be here in Chicago. Thank you so much for spending some time with me this evening. I know you are super tired, and I appreciate every single minute you've given. So I've got one last question, and then you can go.
Awesome. Lay it on me.
What's one beauty thing you cannot live without?
I love BB cream because it's sunscreen. It's moisturizer. It's a little bit of delicate coverage, not too much. I'm obsessed with it. I use Dior, and it's like I don't feel ready for the day. I don't need to wear mascara, like lip gloss, whatever. If I have BB cream on, then I just like I feel good and happy. So that's probably it. That paired with a nice blowout, like you don't even need anything else. You look, you're like, you know those models that you see out walking the world and they just look like undone? Like you can look deliberately undone even though you pulled out of bed if you have like a clean face. So that's my favorite thing.
Nice.
I love deliberate. That. And meanwhile, I'm like, you know, bedhead or whatever, but I like it.
You look fantastic. So I totally appreciate you and thank you for your time today. Everyone, go to styleseat.com. Download the app in the App Store today. Book you an appointment to get any kind of service you want. And definitely, if you are a stylist and you're watching, sign up for StyleSeat today because you can grow your business by, it sounds like 70%, which I think sounds like an amazing, amazing opportunity for you to really grow your business, reach customers. I don't know. Honey, who doesn't like that? So thanks so much, Melody.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. I'll see you soon, hopefully.
All right. See you soon.
All right. Bye.